Hello everyone and welcome back to Talk Time Tuesdays with The Whole Parenting. My name is Louise, I am a mom and I am also a family and child development consultant. Now today I am going to talk to you about five simple ways that you can connect with your children. Now I'm about to make a very strong statement, and that statement is that outside of a wonderful, nutritious, balanced diet, the connection that we establish with our children is by far the most important part of parenting. It opens up the way for every other parenting task to be easier. Now, it's kind of like a gateway, a parenting gateway. Recently, I spoke to you about one of the benefits of connecting with our children, and it is about the importance of connection on our children's emotional well-being. Fortunately, this is not the only benefit of connection. Some other benefits of connection are: one, it makes it easier for our children to listen to us. It also makes it easier for them to accept guidance from us because they want to please us. It also establishes bonding and attachment between us and our children. It aids in brain development. It improves learning. It creates resiliency in children, resiliency to things like bullying. It prevents children from becoming bullies. And it ensures that you are your child's compass, North Star, so to speak. Now, without a positive connection between ourselves and our children, it is almost impossible to parent effectively. Luckily, every interaction that we have with our children is an opportunity for us to connect with them, even when they misbehave. And now this is quite important for us to remember. And it's important that we try to make the best use of every parenting opportunity that we get so that we can connect with our children. Now I'm going to go straight into the five simple things that we can do to establish a stronger connection with our children. And the first one is that as far as possible, pay attention to your child when that child requests your attention. It shows them that we care, that we are interested in what they're saying to us, that we want to know more about them. And what that does is it kind of gives them a blueprint of how to treat others as well. So for instance, when they are older and teenagers in that stage where they don't really want to spend that much time with us anymore, it creates the type of connection and has given them that type of blueprint on how to treat others, so that they will still want to give us a little bit of their time even when they don't want to spend much time with us. Now, as sure as the sun will rise tomorrow, our children will be sure to interrupt us and want our attention when we're in the middle of something important. It is bound to happen. Now, we won't always be able to attend to their request immediately. When your child comes to you and he or she says to you, "Mommy, can you come and do this with me?" or "Mommy, can you come and look at this that I made?" and you don't have the time because you're in the middle of sending something off, like an email or finishing a project or something like that, what you need to do is ensure you let your child know that you've heard them. That's important. So you say something like, "Yes, honey, I know you want me to have a look at your painting now. I can't do it right now because I'm in the middle of sending off something very important, but I want to see what you need to show me. So let's make a time that we'll come back to this." It's not going to be in the far distant future. You want to do something that's very soon. So in a matter of minutes or in a matter of an hour or something like that, you say to them, "Honey, can we do this just a little bit later? Can we do this after dinner? Can we do it just before dinner? Can we do it when I'm cooking?" Or, you know, something like that. So they know that you've put a time on it and you're quite specific. It shows them that you think what they want to show you is important, and it makes them feel important. even though you are not able to attend to them immediately. Now, the next thing that we want to talk about is special time. You want to spend 10 to 15 minutes per day with your child, of special time with them. And this has to be with the one child. You don't bring all your children together and spend special time with all of them at one time. It has to be with one child. And I do understand that some families have 4 and 5 children and parents are busy. If you can't do 10 to 15 minutes per day with each child, at the very least, do 5 minutes with each child. It will help you to save time later on, trust me when I say that. And we will continue to speak about how important special time is sometime later, because this will take quite a lot of talking. But give them some amount of time per day and you will see the change in their behaviors and you will see the change in your relationship. It cannot be while you're doing something for yourself, like running errands. You shouldn't turn it into a play date with them and another child, and you must avoid breaking your special time date with your child. As much as possible, try to keep that special time date per day. Also, alternate between child-directed time and time that you direct, but that's still about your child. So an example is a parent directed time could be the use of a mother child journal. It will help you and your child to learn about each other. You learn about your child learns about you in a fun and effective way. You still direct that time, but it is time that is about your child. The next one is to connect on their level. Now, a simple thing like stooping or sitting down lower to connect with your child eye to eye is a simple but effective parenting technique that could build connection so very quickly, but also could help with your child's behavior. And we'll go into how it helps with behavior later on. But let's go into how it helps with connection just a bit. Being on the same eye level with your child helps him to feel safer and more in control. By doing so, you physically indicate, because you're coming down a little bit lower, so you're physically indicating that you're giving your child your full attention. It also signals that you're willing and ready to connect with him. The next way to connect with your child in a simple but effective way is the Gottman 5-1 method. Now, as much as we want to do our best, as much as we try to do our best, as much as we apply ourselves to doing our best, because we are human beings, we will mess up. It's unfortunate, but it happens. And an accumulation of negative interactions between you and your child, or you and anybody else, will cause a breakdown in relationships. According to Dr. John Gottman of the Gottman Institute, we need 5 positive interactions to neutralize a negative interaction. So if you snap at your child because she left her empty plates on the table again, you can make up for this with 5 positive interactions. So maybe you give her a hug the next time you see her, you give your child a compliment, or you give her immediate attention when she requests your attention. So 5 different positive interactions to neutralize the negative interaction that you had previously. Now, this is a proven and research-based strategy, and it works for adult relationships, and it also works for parent-child relationships. Try it and see how it works. Now, the 5th and last one that I want to talk about today is developing family rituals. Family rituals that will develop connection between you and your children. So for instance, maybe you might say you do breakfast together every weekend, maybe on a Sunday morning, maybe on a Saturday morning. Maybe you say that you go for a walk in the park on a Friday evening to bring in the weekend. Special ritual maybe to begin the Christmas season, a special secret family handshake that you do whenever you meet each other after a separation. Whatever it is, make sure it's something that connects you to each other, something everyone in the family enjoys and looks forward to, and something that you can maintain. Now that's all 5 simple ways to connect with your child. I hope you got something from today's talk, and I hope you'll be able to implement it into your parenting practice. Now if you found this video helpful, I would like you to share it with somebody who you think may benefit from it. Also, I'd like you to like and follow us on all our platforms so you know when we next release a video. And I hope to see you here next Tuesday. Have a lovely week and see you next Tuesday.